Everything is fine. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, fine.
Why it's disconnected every time, every few minutes after?
Yes, 40 minutes after 40 minutes, our session is stopped by default only because I'm not using paid version of Zoom.
Okay. Sorry. Okay.
No issue. Okay, good. But it's yeah, really okay. Everyone I am appreciating today, guys. Okay, everyone, 26 member means what? Good, very good.
Yeah.
Okay, so your question is what? We can return entity. We can return it again if we need what ID. Then what is that? What is the use if we are getting directly, right? Conversation will take much time, na? Come on. Then what? Unnecessary. Our application performance will reduce or not?
Yes, Ravi.
Yes, sir.
So, yes, Ravi. If you are the software engineer, then you have need to take care of those things also, performance, memory, age, and everything. Why we are learning data structure? Okay, so now data, right? Delete, right? Sorry, yeah. Update the product. Update the product means what? Product itself only, right? We have need to update the product only, right? So here, what is the naming convention? We will take product. Means what? By seeing the method, we can understand, right? We have need to update the product data, right? So it's a return type. We are taking nothing. It will not return anything. Okay, this method will not return anything. After then what? Delete, right? We are going to delete the product also now in our application. Product, right?
Yes.
Delete, but yes, when, but what in the table, right? In the table, just normally, guys. Okay, just think about that. Our 1 minute. This is the table is there, right? This is the table is there. Okay, fine. 1 minute. This is the table. In the table, one record is there. If we want to select one particular record in the table, so we have need to take what? One field, right? Come on. Then we can able to fetch this data, na?
Yes, Ravi.
Yes.
So, so we have need to just what? I'm taking the ID, right? ID. Okay, so our ID in which data type we can take, guys? Come on, our ID will be
integer.
Correct. So what is the input here? We will take
integer ID and product type.
Integer, right? Good. So its return type also void only. Void means what? Nothing it will return. Come on, just it will delete our product itself only, right?
Yes,
okay, fine. Yes, now so but what is that? We have need to select one product. We have need to take what? One product itself only, right? So product, if we select one product, then what is that for the selection purpose also? What we have need? Integer itself only, right?
Yes, Ravi, integer. Yes. ID.
Yeah, ID, right? Okay, fine. So, but what is that? What it will return? Like one product, right?
Product.
Our return type is what? Product itself only, product. Right? Okay, good. So, okay, fine. Come here. Okay. In the database, right? Multiple record is there. Multiple record is there. Means what? Whenever we will select all record, means what? We will get what? List of record, na? Come on.
Yes.
Yes. We are get, we will get what? List of record, right? Come on, guys.
Yes,
correct. Yes.
Okay, so fine. Now so then what is that? So what is the return type of our what? Get all product. Okay,
list of product.
Okay, product, list of what? Product only, right?
Yes,
list of what? Product. Good.
So, and also patch API is also required now, updating for one record.
I will implement it, man. Give the time. Okay, give the time. I have need to take to take care each and everyone. Why you are don't like this much hurry if you are there? Okay, so for you, our YouTube channel is there. Okay, not a session. So I'm saying that, okay, I have, if I'm taking care of all those things, why I will escape that one?
Okay. I mean, next line you write, I think maybe I saw that's why I'm saying.
No, when the time will come, I will, okay, I will, don't suggest me because I prepare this mini project now. Then I know that when I have need to introduce what. Okay, let's move on. So fine, this five implementation, but what is where we will write the business logic now, guys? Come on, this is the interface, right? This is the interface. Then we have need its implementation class now. Yes. Come on.
We have
need to write its implementation class also, right? So what we will do now, new class and what? Service.impl. Here what we will take? Product, service, impl. Very good. Now finish it, okay, fine. Now so after then, good. So this is the implementation class, guys. Okay, so one is stereotype annotation we have need to apply, then our IOC container will know that. Okay, this is the service class, right? At the rate service annotation. We have apply on the top of what? @service annotation. Then by seeing this @service annotation, our IOC container will understand what? Oh, this is the business class. Okay, so fine now, guys. So, but what? Where we wrote all abstract method, right? About this class, it's like in interface, right? In interface.
Yes. Oh. Yes. Implement.
Okay. So. Okay, fine. But what? This is the class, and it's a super. Super is what? Interface. Then between what? Interface and the class. What is the real? Keyword, right?
Implement keyword.
We will use what? Implement keyword, right? Implements keyword. I product service, right? Okay, fine. Now, fine, good. So what we will do now, all abstract methods, see this here, we are getting red mark, right? So means what? It's saying that our compiler, please, what?
Override all
abstract method. So add the implementation class. We got all. Alt shift S plus V. Our service implementation class also ready. But these method will interact with database, right? Database also. And our what? That layer is what? DAO layer. Our DAO layer is nothing but product service, right? Come on. If we want to perform what? Save, update, delete operation, where these method is there in the data JPA repository only, right?
Yes, Ravi.
Okay. So if we want to use our data JPA repository methods, then what we have need to do it now, guys? We have need to make has a relation between these two classes.
Yes.
So here what we will do now, take the product repository repo, right? product repository repo. Okay, fine now. Okay, so what we will do now? At the rate, we will apply at the rate auto wire. Auto wire, right? Okay, so now between our service IMPL to what? Our service IMPL to product repository. Relation is stable, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now these two area we completed, right? These two part we completed, right?
Yes, Ravi.
This area we completed. Now we have need to work on this area, right? Come on.
Yes.
Okay, fine. So let's develop, right? Let's develop our controller class. Okay, so now right click, new, take the class. Okay, scam.rk.controller, right?
Controller.
Let's take product controller. Now I'm taking here what product. Okay, product controller. Now finish it. Now this is our product controller class, guys. Okay, so yes, if we want to make this class as a what, rest controller, then what annotation we will apply it now, guys?
At the rest controller.
Okay, fine. Now I want what class level path also. For that, what annotation?
Request mapping.
Request mapping, right? Here I'm taking what product only, right? Product, fine. Okay, so after then what we have need to stable relation between what our service layer to what our controller, right? So what relation we will stable it now? Come on, has a relation. Okay, fine. So how we are establishing the has a relation?
Private product service.
I product service.
And product service.
Okay, fine. Either it then. On the top of this attribute, what annotation we will apply now? At the rate auto wire. Now our what? Between what? Controller to service class, right? Service interface. Our relation is stable, right? Come on.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Means what? Now all relation be stable between what? Our interface to classes, right? Come on. Now means what?
Yes,
now we have need to write the logic, right? We have need to write business logic, okay? A logic to perform what? Save, update, delete, all those things, right? Come on.
Yeah, yes.
Okay.
Yes,
okay, fine. So let's work on this area, guys. Okay, let's work on. Okay, so first what we will do it now, guys. So come here, okay? Come in the service implementation class, right? Come in the, we have need to perform save operation, right?
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, fine. So for the save operation, this method is there, na? Come on.
Yes.
Okay, fine now, guys. See, so many modification will come, guys. So many modification will come because this is the project, okay? Not a concept I'm explaining. So many modification will come, but when I will reach on that step, right, then I will explain. But I have need to hold your hand like lower to up, right? Don't use show your talent, guys. Okay, by if you're talking in the session, by like talk only I can understand how much you have the knowledge and all those things. Okay, so but the thing is, give that authority to me, okay, to explain it. Okay, I will explain, I will touch each and everything, guys. Okay, each and everything. I will not accept escape on anything. Okay, so just give that freedom to me. Okay, give that freedom to me. Okay, so now focus on this area. This is the product, right? What this is, what we have need to save the product now. Come on.
Yes.
Okay. Sir. Okay. Fine. Okay. So how we can, what is the method in the JPA repository now? So we have need to take repo.save, right? We have need to save the product now.
Yes, sir.
I think 3 days before itself only I inform in the group, guys, focus on exception handling plus what JPA, right? I said already, if you are not watching those video, guys, that is not my mistake, because already I completed, right? Data JPA. Come on.
Yes, Ravi, yes.
Okay, fine. So here what we will do now, we will pass this object, right? Product object, we will pass in the argument, right? So fine now, guys. Okay, after then what? We will take the return as what? ID, na? Come on.
Yes,
Ravi.
Here, what will happen now? Our data will store, right? Our data will store here. Our data will store. After then we have need to return what? ID itself only, right? So after then what? We will take it now. Product, right? Product ID we have need, right? So here we will take what? P dot get product ID, right? Product ID. It will return, right? Now fine, our method is ready. Still, I said na, I will give the modification, because see, I'm not doing calculation and all those things. Still, I'm not writing GST logic and a discount, guys. Okay. I said because initially only I said that, give that freedom to me, when time will come then I will explain it. Okay, so fine, still, because this is the business class, na, we have need to write the business logic itself only, but basic understand first. I will give what basic in understanding, then I will implement what business logic, then you guys will catch easily, guys. Okay, this is the what explanation style. Okay, my explanation style is this one only, guys. Okay, so fine now. Okay, so let's move on. Okay, so for about this method, we have need to write one controller itself, na? Come on.
Yes.
Okay, so come in the product controller class. Okay, so what we will do now, let's specify one method now. Okay, so public after then what? Public we have need to write one what? Controller method. Then what is the return type now, guys? Response entity. Come on, forgot. I still remember it.
Remember, Ravi. Yes.
Okay. Then it will return what? Then it will return a string itself only, right? Now what we will do now? Save what product? Save product, right?
Yes, Ravi.
Yes, Ravi.
One minute. Yeah. Save product. Okay. Now tell. Okay. Because already last week only I completed. Now let's see. Give the, I want everyone response, guys. Okay. Unmute yourself. I need that response. Okay. Unmute yourself. Now just null I'm returning. So okay. I explained media type in annotation and the last time, right?
Yes.
Okay. So last time I completed, what is the both media type annotation?
Added response entity and request entity.
Only one, yes. Person?
Request body and response body.
Response body.
Yes, good. Response body and a request body, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Request body only.
Okay, so request body only, right? Okay, response body and a request body. Okay, so fine. Now which one is mandatory and which one the optional, guys?
Response body optional. Response
body is mandatory.
Sorry,
request body is mandatory.
Request body is mandatory.
Okay.
Response body is included in this controller.
Okay, but for what purpose we are writing this method now? For the saving the product, right?
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, so means what? Our end user will send what? Product data, right? Product data in the JSON format. Our what? Then this annotation we will use in the what? We will use this annotation, right? And this annotation is a mandatory annotation, na? Come on, guys.
It's
mandatory.
Because here we will send the JSON data, then we can store it, means what? Then we can save the data, na? Come on.
Yes, Ravi, yes.
Okay, fine now, guys. Okay, come here. So means what the methodology? Save methodology, right? So what annotation we will apply on the top of this method now? for the saving purpose, post mapping na. Okay. So let's take what URL as a save now, guys. Okay. So save here. Okay. Fine now. Okay. So but what we have need what to, if our end user is sending our JSON data and XML data, then how we are reading that XML data and the JSON data using which annotation now, guys? In the argument, come on. Last
thing. Address request body.
Yes, @ request. Yes, @ request body and what product data? Na, come on.
Yes, Ravi.
Product.
Product P.
Product, right? Fine. Okay, good. So okay, good. Now our method is ready now, guys. So but what we have need to save this data, whatever our JSON data will come, we have need to store in the database. Na, come on.
Yes, Ravi. Yes.
Okay. So but what our application should interact with what our service plus what DAO layer, right? So where yes, we are Ravi. Writing where we are writing that what logic in the service class? Na, come on.
Yes, Ravi. Yes.
Okay. Service dot what? Service dot save method. Yes. We have need to call and yes, what we have need to do now? We have need to pass this product inside this argument. Na, come on, guys.
Yes.
Okay. Fine. Then what? This method will return what? Integer ID, right? Come on.
Yes, Ravi. Integer ID.
Okay. Fine, guys. Okay. Good. Very good. Okay, so fine. So now what we will do now, but here return we are taking the return type as a string. Okay, so what we will take is string data, right? String data equal to just what I'm doing now. I'm writing one message, guys. That message will go to our front end application, right? Front end application means what? Product. Just I'm writing product data save, right? Product data save plus what? ID. This is the ID. Okay, this is the message, right? So fine now, guys. So then now we have need to return the response also. Now come on.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, for that we have need to construct what? Response entity, right?
Response entity.
Okay, so response entity res equal to what? New response entity, right? Response entity. Inside that, what we will do now? How many parts is serving now, guys? Two parts. So okay.
Okay.
In the body, in this time we will pass this data, right? This data. Okay. Yes. After then what? HTTP. HTTP status.
No guys,
come here. I know that you guys will tell this one only, right? Okay, we are going to save it. Means what? We are creating something in the server. Nah, come on. I already explained for the post what I wrote, guys. See this already I said, right? Post means what? To create a new resource at a provider side. Come on.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay. Okay. So we understand, right? Like status code also, right? 100 to 100, like 200 to 300, 300 to like that code also there, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But whenever we are creating something in the server, for that code is what? 401. 401. What is the code now, guys? To generate that code, dot create one enum is there, right? Enum. Now I'm opening this in implementation. See this what create, sorry. Oh, it's my mistake. Oh, sorry. And not a 401, guys. 201, right? 20. It's my mistake. 201.
For the success, right?
Okay, 201, right? 201 means what? Created. Okay, 200 means what? Success means what? Okay, means our API is running successfully. Means what? If we are getting 201, means what? Means our API is successfully something created. Means we are performing post operation, right? Come on.
Yes.
Okay. Similar multiple. See 206, what? 300, right? Move permanently. 1 minute. 500 also. 405, right? 405. Not found. So many, so many these things is there. But when we are working on what? Post methodology, and even already at the time of explanation also, I said already, right? To create a new resource at a provider sites. Focus on this one, right? Focus on what wording I'm using. Create, right?
To create a resource at
provider. Okay.
Yes, Ravi.
So now create here, what we are taking now? Create now, come on.
Yes, Ravi.
Based on our theory, our API is going on now, come on.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, fine now, guys. So fine, good. So here what we will do now, guys. Here we will do the, we will return this entity, right? Okay, fine. Now our save control, guys. So many modification will come. I will play with your brain today. Okay, just be ready. Okay, just be ready for that. Okay. So now, okay, now. com.rk. Now I'm running this application, right? So okay, fine. Let's run the application. Okay, fine now. Okay, so but the methodology is post. We can make the request on browser. Come on. This methodology is post. We have need. So now currently I'm using Postman client. Okay, currently I'm using Postman client. Later we will give other implementation, right?
Okay.
So just I'm opening our Postman client. Okay. So fine, our Postman client is ready now. Okay, so fine now. So come here, okay. Okay, let's take what methodology will be put, right? Sorry, post. Okay, we are selecting the post. Now HTTP localhost, right? Localhost 9595/ class level we took product, right?
Product save.
Right after then you have to select the body, right? Select the body. Okay. I'm removing this one and select what? JSON XML, sorry, JSON data, right? JSON data content type. This one is what? Content type. Okay. So here what? One object. We have need to save one object means what? One curly bracket, one open bracket. Nah, come on. One open bracket, yes, one close.
Yes.
It will denote what? One object. Fine. Come on.
Yes.
Okay. Come here. Come to what? Product model class, guys. Okay. So we have need to what? Store the data, right? This ID will generate automatically. We don't have need to take care, right? Now another one. Yeah. So product code, right? Product code. Okay. Now I'm taking in the double quote product code. Fine. Product code. Okay. Let's take Samsung itself only, guys. Okay. I'm taking Samsung. Product code Samsung only. Let's take. Okay. Fine. After then what? Another one is I'm taking
product,
what?
Product cost.
This one must be matched, guys. Otherwise the data will not store, right? So come here. Okay. Now, okay. Paste it. Okay. Now colon here product cost. Let's take what? 50,000, right? Okay. Fine. Another one is what? Vendor,
product,
right?
Product vendor.
Let's take product vendor. Product vendor. Okay, fine. Product vendor. I'm taking what? Samsung, na? So, Korean. Korea spelling is correct.
Okay,
leave it, no issue. Okay, Korea, right? Korea. Let's take vendor we have need. Okay, Okay, let's take Samsung PVT. Samsung PVT. Okay. Okay, leave it. Okay. Samsung PVT. Okay, fine. Oh, this is the data, guys. Okay, don't worry. This one will calculate. We will, our end user will not give. Okay, our end user will not give this one. Okay, this one will calculate in the, we will calculate in the business class, means what, service class only, right? So now what I'm going to do now, I'm going to make the request. Okay. Okay. No issue. Okay. No issue. We are getting what? 404, guys. Okay. We are getting what? 404. Here, PROTUCT, right? Spelling is mistake.
Yeah.
Now make the request. What message we are getting here now, guys? Come on.
Product data save,
right? Now come to our, come our database, guys. Okay. See this. Don't worry. The like row will, we can't in the database, based on the database table only, like this row and column will be there, guys. Okay, we will not decide. Okay, column, right? This one is, we are saying that this one is what, guys? This one is what, row or column?
This one is row.
And this is the column, right?
Column.
Okay, we can't decide the column, right, in the database table. Okay, based on the database table, the column will generate. Okay, so here, see this product code, product cost this much, right? And what product vendor is Samsung. Product vendor is Samsung. And GST and a discount is still null, na?
We have need to calculate
inside the business logic, guys. Okay, now come here. Okay, so where the service class. Okay, fine. So here we have need to write the business logic, right? For the discount purpose as well as what? For the discount purpose as well as what?
GST,
right? GST, good. So what is the, based on one product, how much GST in India now currently, guys?
18%.
Okay, get product, first we have need to get product, right? After then what, we will take this product cost, right? This is the product code, sorry, not a product code, we have need to cost. Okay, here what we are doing now, we are getting the product cost, right? 1 minute, let's stop. Okay, so double cost, we are getting the cost, right?
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, yes, so first what we will calculate, what based on that like a product amount, we will give the discount, right? So how much we will give the discount? 12%, right? Okay, so P dot what, set what, product discount, we have need to set the product discount. Here what we will take now, cost, whatever current cost is there, right? Whatever current cost is there, current cost into
50,000
12 by
100
into 12 by 100, right? Come on.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay. Current GST is what? Set product GST, right? Means what? Cost into
two
what?
By 100.
18, na? Current GST is
18
by 100, right? Now our logic is completed, right? Our logic is completed. Okay, fine. Now, so we have need to what, fetch all record also, right? We have need to fetch what, all record, whatever our record is there, we have need to fetch it. So let's first work on this area also, right? Let's work on this area. Okay, later we will run our application. So here what, so fine.
Product deposit data.
Mute yourself, guys. Noise is actually, I don't know from where some noise is coming. Yeah. Okay, so list, we are getting the list of data. We have need to get what list of data means what we have need to select the data from the database. So for that purpose, what we will do it now, guys. So already, right? Already what? List of get all product is there, right? Get all product is there. Now, so just return, no, nothing we have need to do it now. So if we want to select in the data JPA, in the data JPA, one method we learn, right? Repo dot what find all method was there. Now, come on, this method is returning list of all record.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, fine. Now come in the controller class. Okay, come in the controller class. Our API will do, why we will do, see explicitly. Now public what request, sorry, response. Sorry guys, response entity, right? Response entity, and it will return what? And this method will return what?
List of product,
right? Okay, yeah. List of, yes, we are taking the generic type of list of product. Fine. Okay, now get all product, right? So fine, now guys, just return null for the temporary purpose, right? Okay, good. So we have need to perform select operation. Come on guys, at the rate get mapping for get that mapping. Get mapping,
yes. Our fetching records,
we will specify URI as all, right? Come on,
yes,
so many modifications, yes, still. Just we are preparing pillar, guys. Okay, so many modification will come in this project. Okay, focus on this area. If basic is right strong, then whenever I will implement what logging activity as well as what exception handling plus what business logics, just I will write business logics also, right? So then you guys will catch easily the things, guys. Okay, at the rate get mapping, right? At the rate what get mapping, fine. Fine now guys, so here what we will do it now in the controller itself only, right? So here let's fetch the data. Service dot what get all product, right? And this one is returning what? List of data, right? Come on, list of product. Now,
yes, Ravi. Yes,
okay,
yes, product.
List of product. Okay, so here we are getting list of data. Fine, we are getting the list of data here itself only. So after then what we will prepare? We will prepare the response body, right?
Yes
Ravi.
Response body, right? Response entity, inside that what?
No,
list of product, right?
Yes, sir.
List of product RS equal to new response entity. Fine. Okay, fine now guys. Okay, so here what we will pass, list of data. Here list of data and HTTP status code, what will be now guys? That
okay.
Means 200 means what? Our API is running successfully, right? Okay, fine now guys. So here RES. Okay, we will return the response entity, right? RS. Okay, fine. Fine now. Or this select methodology also, select the data from the database methodology also, we completed now guys. Okay, we completed now. Okay, so now let's run our application. Here controller product repository, 1 minute, this one. Okay, now run the application now. Okay, open the postman now guys. Okay, open the postman now, save the data, right? Because already everything is there. Now product one is saved, right? Now refresh it. One data is came now, come on.
Yes
sir,
here take Nokia and let's take 4, right? 4000. And here what? Nokia, right? Oh, sorry. Nokia. Perfect. Now save it, guys. Okay. Two data saved, right? Come in the database. Yes, come in the database. Yes, come in the database. Yes. See this, guys. Now discount and GST.